In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure Windows Server if you want to install SharePoint Server 2013 on it. On the one hand, this includes the assignment of permission to the SharePoint Server Administrator, and on the other hand, this includes the configuration of server roles. Although the last configuration step can also be done by the prerequisites installer, I suggest to watch the video so you can see what actually is done by the installer. The video is part of a series of 6 videos showing you the installation of SharePoint 2013. I'm going to install SharePoint on 2 different virtual machines, where the left one is used to run Active Directory and the right one is used to run SQL Server and SharePoint. Open Server Manager and click Manage to add roles and features. On the left side, select a role-based or feature-based installation type and proceed to the next screen where you can select the server you want to deploy the roles. First, select the application server role, and second, if you scroll down a little bit, you need to select the web server IIS role. If prompted, add required features. Skip the features dialog and proceed to the selection of role services for both roles. Select the role services as shown in the video and, if prompted, add required features. In case you might wonder, the role services selected here are also the role services configured by the SharePoint 2013 prerequisites installer. Review your settings and proceed with installation. Once the installation has finished, you can see the newly activated roles on the server. As I said earlier, we need to manually assign permission to the SharePoint Setup Administrator, and this account needs to be in the admin administrators group of each server where SharePoint should be installed. Open Server Manager and click Tools and Computer Management to check if the SharePoint Setup Administrator has been added to the local administrators group. Open local users and groups, check groups and double click administrators. And here you can see the SharePoint Setup Administrator has been added to the local administrators group. So the server is okay in order to install SharePoint 2013. So what to do next? You can have a look at one of the other videos about software and hardware requirements, Active Directory, SQL Server, Windows Server or SharePoint 2013. Or you can go to my blog and have a look at updates, errata, scripts or tips and tricks. As you know, I offer professional SharePoint training in addition to my free training. The SharePoint installation training material contains a PDF guide, and you can use this guide either to manually create a SharePoint form or to automatically create a SharePoint form. And it doesn't matter which form. You can create a 3-tier form, 2-tier, 4-tier or a development environment. And as I said, you can do it all automatically using up to 46 PowerShell scripts. And if you're stuck in the middle of the installation and have problems, you can use the troubleshooting tips. And of course, there is bonus material included.